Last comic of the night, guys. Give him everything you got. He's going to do the same for you. M. Dot White.
What's up, Fort Worth? Yeah. No. I know it's the end, but we're going to act like this motherfucker back, okay? Y'all ready? I said, what's up, Fort Worth? Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. All these white women in here, we ain't acting like we ain't got no sense. How y'all doing? All right. I see you two by yourself. You third wheeling right here? You not? Do you don't know them? You don't know them? You do?
I do.
Okay, well, me and you can hang out after the show. I'm totally down. I'm like fucking single. I got kids. I'm looking for somebody with good credit, so it works out. Shit, it works out. Goddamn. Where are weed smokers at? Anybody smoking tonight? Anybody smoking? All right, well, it's fucking, we having a meeting after the show. I mean, let's fucking get together and make that shit happen, you know? I really am on child support, man. Anybody else on child support? I'm looking at all the brothers. I ain't looking at no white people anyway. I'm looking at all the brothers, like three of y'all right here. The white people don't get them put on child support. They get alimony and shit. We don't want that shit. You keep that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I pay for these two little bitty bitches. I ain't paying for no grown bitch. That ain't happening. I don't give a fuck. What y'all talking about? Shit, anybody drinking tonight? Put your drinks up. Let's make a toast. 2017 is coming to an end. If you did everything you have wanted to do this year, if you haven't, get that shit out now. So I am trying to fuck a white woman, by the way. I haven't did that this year. I had a Mexican and an Asian. That was crazy. The Asians are crazy. That shit is sideways, too, by the way. Just, I know y'all been thinking about that shit. That shit is sideways. Hey, real quick, white people, y'all still spanking y'all kids? You still spanking y'all kids? Yeah. I grew up wishing I would get a spanking. I never knew what the fuck a spanking was. I wish I got that shit, because we get ass whoopings. Like, black people give out ass whoopings. You don't get no spanking, you get your ass whooped. That's what's going to happen as soon as we get to the house. And so, like, check this out. One day, my daughter got in trouble. 8 years old, she got in trouble. I never normally spank her, but this time I got to get on that ass. You know what I'm saying? So I'm in the room, I'm telling her ass, like, bah! You better not, bah! Ever do that shit again. Bah! My mama walked past the room and was like, man, let me get some of that shit. Nigga, that shit look too good. Let me get some of that shit. I was like, mom, get your ass out of here. She's like, nah, nigga, I remember I used to whoop your ass like that. That shit look good, nigga. You don't get your ass out of here and go roll a blunt. I'm gonna smoke when we get done. Yeah, damn, man. Just let me whoop her ass. She was like, oh, nigga, just saying. I remember when your daddy punched you in the throat. That shit was cool. Like black people are abusive, you know what I'm saying? My grandma used to throw ashtrays at motherfuckers. You get in trouble. And then I'm talking about the little glass ones, them little motherfuckers. I'm trying, that shit hurt. I got a knot in my head right now, that's why I got this hat on. I was 8 when that shit happened. Now I got a kilo in the back of my head or some shit. That should be looking down. You don't see somebody with a kilo in the back of their head? Shit look nasty. Look like a barbecue brat or some shit. Hey. You ever had this happen to you, man? You ever had this happen to you? Like, I don't fucking speak no Spanish. I don't know why this dude came up to me, but Spanish dude came up to me, don't speak no fucking English, and asked me, he was like, el Walmart? I was like, what? El Walmart. I was like, oh, you wanna know what Walmart is? And he was like, yeah, see. I was like, I did the best Spanish I could do. I was like, el go down there? El go down it and take it the left. I said, only Spanish word I knew was yeah. And take it the white at the Walmart. He's like, yeah, Walmart. I was like, Home Depot right on side of that motherfucker too. I know where you're going. You're going to price comparison shit. I know what's happening. I seen a mariachi band on the roof. That's some bullshit. And they was up there hitting nails. They're like, this shit is crazy. With like 12 Coronas. And they be having their babies on the roof early. You ever notice that shit? Like, you ever seen like Hispanic people working on the roof? It'd be like 5-year-olds up there and shit. You know? And that motherfucker was dragging the bird up the ladder too. I was like, what the fuck is this shit about? That shit really happened. That was my neighbors. Just one minute, I was sitting in the car smoking the blunt. I was like, it's a 5-year-old walking up a ladder with a case of beer. Like, taking my daughters on the roof and shit. I was like, we gotta get comfortable, I guess, try to see what the fuck it's about. Let's try to figure this shit out, how that shit happened. Any e-cig smokers in here? e-cigarette smokers. We got one and shit. And I hate that it was a dude, because that dude, that shit like gay as a motherfucker. I think e-cigarettes are like gay. It like give you a grand entrance every time you blow smoke out. You be like, and it be so much fucking smoke, you can just walk through and be like, da-da-da-da. I'm here, motherfucker. He's like, we know you've been here, but every time we see that shit, it's a grand entrance. Because that shit just cover up your whole face, don't it? You know what I'm saying? Or you ever seen somebody riding down the road and blow that shit out? You think they fucking car on fire. You're like, oh shit, hey nigga, slow down. That shit is going, that shit finna blow up there. You're like, oh, that's an e-cigarette, that's what it was? Like, that's a lot of fucking smoke. That's like a pound of smoke. You blow that shit in the trash bag, you might fill that bitch up. That's what I'm saying. That's all I'm fucking saying. I don't care, shit, I don't care. Y'all heard this restaurant called the Cotton Patch? Some of y'all might know where the fuck I'm going. So I went to the Cotton Patch, you know what I'm saying? We had my mom's birthday. This was last year, and I'm gonna tell you another story about my mom's birthday right quick. I fucking forgot that motherfucker. My birthday was on the 22nd. I smoked on the 21st, the 22nd, the 23rd, the 24th, the 25th, the 26th, the 27th, and the 28th. I kind of calmed down today. I was like, oh shit, I forgot my mom's birthday on the 22nd. Shit, I'm gonna have to take her out to eat or something. She ain't said the fucked up part, she ain't saying shit. She was like, She just walked through the house, I'm like, no, I'm good. But, so last year we went to the Cotton Patch for her birthday. And, you know what I'm saying, she got a couple of old white friends, a couple of old black friends and shit. Well, in the booth next to her, this old white lady came up to me and said, hey, little nigger boy, come here. I was like, whoa! And as a comic, like, this is a true story. And as a comic, I gotta see what the fuck going on. I don't get mad and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? So I come up to her, and she was like, hey, we need to clear a table full of trays. We need to get the trays off the table. So I'm like, all right, you know, I grab a tray. I take them off the table, you know what I'm saying? I was like, hey, what's your name? She told me her name. I went and got the waiter, and was like, yeah, we want to put all our plates, everybody, she take care of everything over here in the corner. And I was like, hey, I grabbed your plates, right? You know, that's all I fucking said. I was like, hold your thumb up if I grab your plate. I grabbed your plates, right? She's like, I was like, yeah, everything. I grabbed, it's everything. So she had like a $300 bill on that other thing. I was like, fuck that, bitch. You gonna call me a nigga, you gonna pay for it. I don't mind you paying and calling me a nigga. That's fine. That's business. That's how shit works, ain't it? Like, I thought about turning that into a business. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was gonna start selling white people niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like, but just the word. You know what I'm saying? It's like a page and you got like 300 niggas on that motherfucker and shit. Like, you can't get offended and shit. Like, every time you use it, your beef will go off. Boop, 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 boop. You have 299 niggas left. You know what I'm saying? But I thought about it, I was like, what if I put that shit as a commercial? One of these old racist ass, old white men, fuck their head up, won't it? It'd be like, hey, Marianne, come here. Call Jethro and tell them they started selling niggers again and they're really cheap. I don't give a shit, that's funny. You're not saying it no more, is that what you said? You're not gonna say nigger no more? I thought she said, I'm not paying for any niggers, no. I get them out to 12 o'clock all day anyway. Well, I'll tell you what, if you would like any in you tonight. Okay, let me quit. Because I wouldn't fuck her, Yeah, your friend? Yes, no. Hey, yo, my name is M. White. Y'all have a good night, man. Y'all be good.
M. White, one more time. Let M. Dot hit right there. M. Dot.